Guys, it is currently Thursday right now, but when you see this, it will I can't process anything right now. I am just so over the moon. Anyways, the most amazing thing happened today. Like, my life is literally made up. So I was walking along the streets of London with my friend Steve, right? This group of people began approaching us. They were walking the opposite way on the same sidewalk. I'm looking around at the people's faces when I see a familiar face and I hear his voice. And he's like doing kind of like doo-doo-doo-doo-doo-doo, kind of like just singing. It's not humming, but it's like singing to himself. It was Paul McCartney! Paul McCartney walked right by me, and I knew it was him, and I just smiled. I was like, I gave him the biggest smile I could muster. I was like on my own mission, so I couldn't stop, and he was in a big group of people, and they were clearly like security guards of some sort, so I couldn't stop and say hi. Oh, I'm just so happy. I can't. Oh my god. But yeah, I gave him the biggest smile I could. And he continued doing his little singing thing, and he raised his eyebrows and like kind of nodded at me and just kept walking. I was within a foot of Sir Paul McCartney, and he acknowledged my presence. He acknowledged my freaking existence. Guys, I can't believe this. I know it's so little, but if it ever happens to you, you will understand. It is just the biggest thing. Right now, like, holy crap. I pinky swear if I could, it definitely happened. I don't have any photo proof, I don't have any video proof, but my god, it happened. Even if you don't believe me, that's fine. This happened, and I am just like the happiest person in the world, and I had to share it with you. So that's basically it. Oh my god. This man who changed my life with his three friends. Three of his best friends at the time. They just changed my life. And I saw him today. Enter significantly more composed Carly. Every day I wake up and I remember that happened and I freak out a lot inside. And sometimes other people see it and it's not pretty, it's scary. So two Saturdays ago, I had the pleasure of hanging out with Astrid or Katie, whatever you know her by. You may know her from Tumblr as Carnaby Street, or from 8 Vlogs a Week. She doesn't post any videos anymore, but you could always go back and watch her videos. We had a blast. We decided one week we're going to see Backbeat. It was a Saturday night in Covent Garden, which is like the theater district of London. It was extremely busy and tickets were kind of more expensive than they would be in the middle of the week. So we're going to go during the week instead of on the weekends. And I'm so excited. It's gonna be great. We went to the Hard Rock Cafe in London, which I believe is the first ever Hard Rock Cafe in the world. And that was awesome! So many Who and Rolling Stone things especially, but they're also Queen things. I love Queen. And of course, Beatle things! Beatle things! Oh, it was beautiful. They had Paul's fiddle. I didn't know he had one, but he did apparently. They had George Harrison's guitar. They had the shirts of John, Paul, and George. They had Stuart Sutcliffe's bass. And they had various posters and like gold records. And then we went across the street to the Hard Rock Cafe Vault, which is a museum that Hard Rock Cafe owns. It was below the souvenir shop actually, and that had more random things from all these artists and stuff. More Beatle things, of course. They had John's military jacket, and they had his round glasses hanging out from the pocket, which was so cool to see. I don't know, but for some reason that was the piece that really got to me, and I was like, oh, this was on him. Oh my god, John Lennon, why are you so amazing? He also had the harpsichord that was used in Lucy in the Sky with Diamonds. And then they had John's lyrics for Instant Karma, which were typed out on a typewriter, and then had John's little handwritten revisions, which that was cool to see.
Whoa!
What was that?
Nothing.
Moving that party over here now?
Party needs essay.
There's a massage going on. So if you hear any weird noises, that's what it is.
Who are you talking to?
I'm talking to the video. This is how I make videos. What did you think I do in these videos? Like interpretive dance? And then last Saturday, I went on a Beatles tour, which was so cool. They actually have 3 Beatles walking tours in London. I went on the Beatles In My Life tour, and then there's a rock and roll tour, which is obviously not just the Beatles, and then there is the Beatles Magical Mystery Tour walk, which I'm definitely going on at some point. And they're only £6 for students. If you guys are interested and are in the London area, I definitely suggest going on them. The tour guide I had was amazing. And he went to school with Tommy Evans of Badfinger. What? I asked him at the very end, do you know about Badfinger? And he goes, oh my God, just look at you. I went to school with Tommy Evans. I don't know what happened to my face, but the next thing I heard was my friend Ashley going, oh my God, look at Carly's face. It was like the most amazing day, and that was the cherry on top. So this one was amazing. It started at Marylebone. How do you say Marylebone?
Marylebone.
At the Marylebone Tube Station, which is where they filmed the majority of the very beginning of A Hard Day's Night. So that was really cool. There's an M&S there, which is a grocery store, in the actual tube station. And the entrance into M&S is where the Beatles and the fans entered the station. We next went to a little bit right of the station where there's the sidewalk where the Beatles and their fans ran down at the very, very beginning of A Hard Day's Night. And of course, I had to run down it as well. It's been a hard day's night, and I've been working. Next, we went to the registry office where Paul and Ringo got married. Not to each other. Next, we went to the flat where John, Ringo, and Jimi Hendrix lived in the 1960s, and I guess 1970s as well. Ringo first lived in the apartment, and then he rented it out to Jimi Hendrix, and then John eventually moved in. But they didn't all live there together. That would have been awesome. That would have been like the ultimate rock pad back in the day. How cool would that have been? We eventually had to give that flat up because there was a drug bust in the apartment when John was living there. John was actually warned like a couple hours beforehand, hey, this guy's going to bust you for drugs. You should get rid of everything. And John didn't listen. The guy came in and busted him and everything, and there was a case. But then it was eventually revealed that the guy who busted John was planting drugs in every house he busted. So I guess John was let off fine, but then a few years later when Nixon was trying to get John out of the country, get John deported, this whole drug bust came back to haunt him. So it wasn't like the guy planted drugs in John's apartment. He probably did, but there were actually drugs in John's apartment, because I mean, it was John Lennon. If you go there, there's actually a little plaque that says John Lennon lived here. Next, we went to where the old Apple offices, the old Apple offices / Apple boutique was. You know, that's the building with the huge, colorful mural that was there for like a couple days, I think, maybe a couple weeks at the most. It was just this wonderful, beautiful mural, but then all the other businesses around the Apple boutique got angry because first of all, Apple didn't ask for permission, and second of all, there's this huge mural that was just attracting everyone's attention towards that one store, not towards the others. So, they had to paint over it, and since then, they have sanded that, the white paint off, as well as the mural. Next, we went to Jane Asher's old house. It's actually where her family, and Paul McCartney used to live in the 1960s. The next stop on our tour was to the Indian restaurant. Well, it was never actually an Indian restaurant. It was just temporarily changed into an Indian restaurant for the movie Help. It was a restaurant, though, in the 1960s called The Dolphin, and now it is a restaurant called The Giraffe. And then finally, our tour ended at Abbey Road, so I got to go there again, and I got more pictures, but unfortunately, my friend didn't post them yet, so I don't have them to share. But I guess that's good, because then I won't be rubbing it in your face further. I'm sorry for this, but it's like, I want to share with you, because I'm so, so excited. But this time, I had a marker, so I wrote things. If any of you guys come to London, to Abbey Road, look for this. And then next we actually went to Cavendish Avenue on our own, because that's where Paul lives now, 7 Cavendish Avenue, I believe. We weren't exactly sure. Like, we asked our tour guide, where does Paul live now? And he said, I think it's 7 Cavendish, but I could be wrong. We went, and we were like, okay, not sure which one Paul's house is, but all right. So we went to 7 Cavendish Avenue, and we're like, yep, that's definitely it. Because the rest of the houses, like, they're all very beautiful houses, and they all have very nice fences. But this one, 7 Cavendish Avenue, had, like, this big, thick fence where you can't even see the house over it. Like, you can see, like, the top of it, but you can't see anything else. Stalking Paul McCartney 2 days after seeing his face up close. I'm going to answer questions now, because both Brad and Jamie in their latest videos asked the rest of the Beatles Scruffs and the viewers questions. Jamie asked what our favorite Beatles Scruff picture ever is. Beatles Scruff picture? Picture of the Beatles. Wow. Favorite picture of the Beatles ever. Mine is this one right now. It changes all the time, but this is my current desktop picture. Except Ringo's all a derp in it, but whatever. Brad's question was, why do you think the Beatles broke up? What do you think led to them breaking up? I actually made a video about this, I think, last summer, so I'm going to post that in the doobly-doo, so if you guys want to know my full opinion, just check in the underbar. Another thing, a new Beatles channel was brought to our attention recently, and it is called Things We Said Today 7. So I just want to welcome them to the world of YouTube, to the world of Beatles collab channels, because there are quite a few of us now. There's us. The first Beatles collab channel I've ever heard of was, 5 Awesome Beatle Fans, which, like, I was such a huge fan of because I was like, this is such a cool idea! And then I came across the Fab Fans, which turned into the Beatles Scruffs and whatever. But then there was the Revos 9, which was huge news because it was like, what? There's another Beatles collab channel? It was crazy. It was really funny. Unfortunately, they stopped posting videos, which was sad because they were a quality Beatles collab channel and I liked them. We have the Beatles Submarine, of course, and we also have 8 Vlogs a Week. So that's pretty awesome. And I'm sure there are more out there. Like, I'm absolutely positive there are. Yeah, so welcome Things We Said Today 7. Go to their channel, I shall link them for you. Next week you are getting a quality video. Alright, I already have it filmed, I actually do, but I'm probably going to refilm it because I am OCD like that. But you're gonna have a quality video, it's gonna be an informational one, not and look what I did this week one. Okay, bye. You know I feel alright. Oh my god, my life right now, I can't handle this.